Today we're going to talk about creating a new character for your video games and importing it onto your Stencil games. So the first thing you want to do is open up Stencil, go to your dashboard. All I did was click here to create a new actor type, and your character should pop up like so. We're going to go to Google Classroom. I had posted the link for the Universal Sprite page, as it's called. I already have it open up here in a new tab, and you can see our new character is right here. This nifty website, you can change what the person wears. So I'll just quickly make a new costume. Maybe I'll add some chainmail, maybe a little bit of armor. I'll go down. I want to make sure he has some hair. Why not? There we go. Add a couple weapons if you like. Most people like to have some sort of bow, or maybe even want to add a quiver or a shield, something like that. For right now, that's good. You can see he has all of his different animations over here. So the question then becomes, how do we get it from here to our game? So down here, you're going to click where it says Save Result as a PNG. It'll pop up in a little download at the bottom of your screen. What I like to do, just to make it nice and easy, is just drag and drop it onto your desktop screen. I'm going to right click and hit Open With, and I'm going to open it with Microsoft Paint. Now, at the same time, I'm going to go ahead and open Paint again, and you'll see why in just a second. So, first thing I want to do is I want to pick a section of this that makes our character walk right. So his walk right animation is right here. So all I'm going to do is I'm just going to select it, and I'm going to right click and hit copy, and then I'm going to go to my blank Microsoft Paint and hit paste. I will then crop it. Very easy from here on out. I'm going to hit File, Save As, and I'm going to title it Walk Right. I'll go to my desktop screen and I'll leave it. And then you should be able to see it right here on your desktop screen. Perfect. Now, I'm going to come back here to my animations. The animation I want to add, conveniently, I'm going to name it Walk Right. I'm going to click here to add a frame, and I'm going to choose my image, which of course is on the desktop screen. Now, it should look something like this. I want to split it up into different columns. Okay, so you can see I'm at about 9 columns for this one, which is just about right. So I'm going to hit Add. And you can see up here, my character is starting to walk right. But I want to get rid of this white background. So I need to double-click on each image, hit Edit Image. On the left side, on the third tool down on the right, it says Magic Wand Selection Tool. All you're going to do is click in the white area around your character and then hit the Delete button. And you can see it turns it into a transparent background. Now, unfortunately, you have to do this for each character. It doesn't take too long. It takes about less than a minute to do them all. But you can see for each one, it will make it a transparent background, and you'll see why that's important.
Perfect.
Now, instead of doing the same thing for walk left, which we have the option to, walk left is right here. But the nice part about Stencil is if I go up to the Edit tool, I can hit Duplicate Animation. Now I'm going to rename that one. Instead of Walk Right Copy, I'm going to name it Walk Left. And then I'm going to go to Edit again, and I'm going to hit Flip Horizontal. Now I have Walk Right and Walk Left. The last thing I need is an idle. An idle is whenever your character is standing still, what do you want him to look like? So I'm going to choose this one for Walk Right. Okay, so I will just select it. Copy it. I'm going to come back to this screen and I'm just going to hit undo here and I'm going to hit paste and cut. Hit file, save as, and I'm going to name this one Idle Right. Now I'm going to come back to Stencil. I need to add a new animation, and before I forget, I want to name it Idle Right. Same exact process as before. Here's my Idle Right. I want to open it back up. Accidentally double click there. Just want it once. There we go. I want to make it transparent. Hit delete and call it good. Duplicate it one more time. Name it Idle Left this time. And I'm going to flip it just like I did. Now, After I have this done, I can go up to my behaviors. I can hit add behavior, and I can hit two-way horizontal movement. Now this is where you can make it to where your character can go right and left. You've made the animations, now you actually have to program it. So, of course, down here, here are my animations. So, left idle, left animation, walk idle, right, and right animation.